everyone. I'm Nora Ali here with Baker Machado. We've got another big hour coming up today. All right, guys, coming up on Between Bells, she starts eighth grade in 2 weeks, but she's on the cover of Entrepreneur magazine today. We'll meet the young CEO and founder of her own candy company. That's next on Cheddar. Welcome back to Between Bells, everyone. Our next guest goes back to school in about 2 weeks, and she'll have quite the thing to share at eighth grade show and tell.
They still have show and tell.
That's true. Kidtrepreneur Alina Morse is on the cover of Entrepreneur magazine after founding her very own candy empire. Joining us now to tell us how she did it are Alina Morse, CEO and founder of Zolli Candy, and Jason Pfeiffer, editor-in-chief of Entrepreneur Magazine. Thank you so much to both of you for joining us here today.
Thank you for having
us. Thanks for having
us. Congratulations, Alina. This is super exciting. Youngest person ever to be on the cover of Entrepreneur Magazine. What's it going to feel like to tell your friends when you get back to school that this was what your summer was?
Well, it's so crazy. I'm so grateful and so honored to be on a cover that so many amazing people have been on, and that Entrepreneur is shining a light on young entrepreneurs, and that they're saying that age is just a number and that kids can do anything that adults can do.
Yes, I totally get it. And Jason, why was it important to showcase somebody like Alina who's so young, to put somebody like that on the cover of the magazine?
I see so much energy in young people. Like, the energy in entrepreneurship is concentrated in young people. It's really amazing. And I also wanted to really make a statement, because you hear the most ridiculous things about young people, that they're lazy, that they're entitled.
Well, we hear it all day.
Not true. Not true. Ridiculously not true. I meet on a regular basis so many amazing young people who are taking initiative, who are chasing their dreams. It's a hard decision to pick one person to put on the cover, because there are so many amazing ones out there.
It's a great cover, too.
That's really
awesome.
Good cover.
So, Alina, tell us about Zolli Candy.
Because I have a bag in my hand.
I'm going to eat some while you tell us about it, but how did you get the idea? What's the mission? How did it all happen?
So, I came up with the idea when I was 7 years old.
I went to the bank
with my dad. Yeah.
Wow.
And the teller offered me a lollipop. My dad told me that I shouldn't have candy because sugar is terrible for your teeth.
Right.
So I asked him, well, why can't you make a healthy lollipop that's good for my teeth so that I could have candy and it wouldn't be bad for me? Then after about 2 years of research, talking to my dentist and my dental hygienist, and plant trials, we finally created Zolli Pops.
It doesn't taste sugar-free.
What did you do to make it so it wasn't sweet or wasn't bad for your teeth? What sort of ingredients did you find that made it so much better for you?
So I did a lot of research online, but then I also talked to my dentist and my dental hygienist, and they recommended xylitol and erythritol, which are all natural plant-based ingredients from the U.S. All of our stuff is made in the USA.
Uh-huh.
And then we took the ingredient list to
this is
a plant.
Incredible. Three pops is only 30 calories.
Wow, so literally, this serving is a 10... size is three pops. That's very generous.
Yeah, that is.
Wow, thank you.
Well, we just like to say that because we're the after-you-eat treat for a healthy smile, so one after every meal.
Oh, my dentist would have loved this. I'm actually going to the dentist tomorrow, so I'll make sure I tell them about this.
Yeah, dentists love that.
Yes, how were you able to balance, you know, school, about to go to school, and essentially now running this entire company?
Well, during the school year, I split my time into thirds. One-third for the company, one-third for homework, because school is very important, and then one-third for just being a kid.
Yeah.
There's no chance that you're going to quit school, is there?
No, definitely not.
Definitely graduate. All right, Jason, you seem to be very passionate about young entrepreneurs and highlighting them. When it comes to young female entrepreneurs as well, why is that extra important for you to highlight?
Well, for so many, we could go on for hours about that. I mean, listen, there is a female entrepreneurs of any age face significant problems, right? It's harder to raise money. Banks don't take them as seriously. It's crazy that in 2018 we can say that, but that is true. And I think it's so important to put someone like Alina on the cover and inspire the next generation of young female entrepreneurs to say, like, listen, there's still garbage in the world that you have to face. Garbage like investors that don't take you seriously and stuff. But you know what? You can reach amazing heights. There are people there who are cheering you on, who are taking you very seriously, and that you can have an amazing impact even at an age like 13.
Well, and it seems like it's working, because in addition to just making a good product, your sales are doing fantastic, Alina. I mean, going through your sales, they're up 200% from this time last year. You're on track to triple your sales this year alone. What has really been the key to the success in terms of creating this, in terms of driving the sales and getting those good numbers?
Well, I have an amazing team at Zolli Pops, very experienced, very passionate people that just love the company as much as I do, and they work so very hard. and stuff that I'm not very experienced in, such as accounting and logistics, because I haven't gotten to that point in my school career. But also earned media has definitely helped, and just hard work. We are a cause-based organization, so our mission is to help reduce childhood tooth decay. So a
I
lot
can
of
see
people,
why your dentist was very happy to work with you on this.
Yeah, a lot of people are very passionate about this epidemic that we are. So they always love sharing Zollipops, sharing smiles, and just helping everyone smile.
You said you haven't gotten to accounting yet in school, but what are some of the classes that you think have helped you so far in building your own business?
Well, definitely English, because speaking, presentations, things like that, which I do quite a bit. So I get to bring that from my school into interviews, into presentations. That's helpful.
I bet math helps as well too, right? When you're trying to help your accounting team project sales and understanding some of the numbers too.
Yes, definitely. I'm not gonna understand everything because I'm still 13, but it definitely does help. And my team is very understanding, and they always like to help me and make sure I understand everything so that I can be as involved in the company as I would like to be.
All right. Obviously, Alina has an amazing story. What are some other stories that are in Entrepreneur this month in particular that you really want people to learn about this issue?
Yeah, so I mean, this is our, we call it the Young Entrepreneur, the Young Millionaires issue. It's an old phrase that we use, and I redefined it to mean raising millions, selling millions. I'm not really interested in net worth. What I'm interested in is achievement. So some great other stories that we have in here. One is about a company called Kairos, which I don't know if you guys are familiar with, but it's a company based here. They launch companies that are run by young founders that are addressing real world issues, things like elder care, affordability of housing. So that's a really amazing story. And then we also have a great deep dive into Peter Diamandis, a futurist, XPRIZE founder. He has a really fascinating organization or a group inside his company called Strikeforce, in which he has young entrepreneurs join him for 2 years, and anything that they build inside of his organization, they own a piece of. So it's really, it's an incubator inside for young entrepreneurs to come and bring their energy, bring their enthusiasm. The amazing thing about young entrepreneurs is that they think outside the box, they see things in totally fresh ways. Every company, every founder should be embracing that and bringing that into their organization.
Really, really cool stuff.
We're sold.
Appreciate you both joining us here today. Alina Moore, CEO and founder of Zolli Candy, and Jason Pfeiffer, editor-in-chief of Entrepreneur Magazine. Thanks so much.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you for having us.
Coming up on